Hey friends, are you planning a trip to Ladakh via Manali Leh Highway? Well, today in this Express FAQ series on traveling to Ladakh, I am going to talk about what you must not miss on a trip to Ladakh via Manali Leh Highway. So let's get started. Hello, Namaste and Julay. If you're new to my channel, my name is Dheeraj and I run a travel blog, devilonwheels.com. So, what can you explore on Manali Leh Highway? Well, all over this 474-kilometer long Manali Leh Highway, you will come across various sightseeing places and mountain passes that will keep your interest going on. You will be passing at least 5 mountain passes and couple of small beautiful lakes on this journey from Manali to Leh. So if I start from Manali, which in itself is a very major tourist place in northern India, you can go and visit Solang Valley for some adventure activities. Then, about 51 kilometers from Manali, you come to the first mountain pass, which is Rohtang Pass. This pass allows you to enter into Lahaul Valley. As you move past Khokskar, you can watch over the Sisu waterfall from the distance before crossing the Sisu village. Now, once you reach Tandi, you have to visit the only petrol pump which is available on Manali Leh Highway. The next petrol pump that you will be finding will be about 370 or 65 kilometers odd away. So make sure that you tank up over here. At Tandi, you will also find a confluence of Chandra and Bhaga River, after which the river is called Chandrabhaga River. Finally, as the day one ends, you have an option of either staying at Khelong or you can stay overnight at Jispa. In general, I prefer sleeping at Jispa than Khelong because Jispa is much closer to nature. Now on day 2, as you start from Jispa or Khelong, you will be first crossing a small pond which is Deepak Tal, which gives you some decent reflections of nearby peaks. And then you start ascending to the second pass of Manali Leh journey, which is Baralachala Pass. At the base of Baralachala Pass, you will come across beautiful lake Surajtal or Vishaltal. Well, it depends on the season when you are visiting this lake. Towards the end of the season, like September-ish, the water dries up. It does not look that beautiful, but still worth a stop. Now, after crossing Baralachala, you will reach Sarchu, where you enter Ladakh from Himachal. The views suddenly, you know, changes and the valleys become more and more wider and colorful. The journey becomes very, very interesting as you reach Ghataloops, which is a collection of 21 hairpin bends, and that helps you ascend to Nakila Pass, which is the third pass on your journey. From there, you keep ascending and you cross first time 5000 meters of altitude and reach Lachungla Pass. And finally, you start descending towards Pang. You will see amazing landscape between these passes and as you reach Pang. Watch out for those keyholes within the mountains and those soil eroded hoodoos that you can see on top of the mountain layers. It's purely amazing. As you continue further from Pang, you will first enter Mur Plains, where you will find excellent roads and you can also spot wildlife such as kiangs, foxes and marmots. As you reach Debring, it marks the beginning of the last mountain pass of Manali Leh journey, which is Tanglangla Pass. Now finally, after crossing Tanglangla Pass, you descend towards Leh via Upshi and Karu. So you can see the overall journey on Manali Leh Highway is an experience of a lifetime, with some magnificent views of the Trans-Himalayas. I bet you will never have a dull moment on this entire journey from Manali to Leh, and that is why it is known as one of the most adventurous roads in India. Now, in the end, if you found this video helpful, do not forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you have any questions or need any kind of help in traveling to Himalayas, please leave a comment and I'll be more than happy to help you out right away. Till then, my friends, Julie.